Our topic is determination of origin of species from blood. So basics are how the analysis of blood can be done using different instruments. So instrument we will discuss about the spectroscopic technique and the electrophoresis technique. Objective of the present study is to determine the origin of species using blood. The basis of determination of origin of species is the antigens and antibodies which are present in the blood. Antigens and antibodies which are present in the blood help us to determine the origin. So first of all, discuss what are antigens and what are antibodies. So antigen and antibodies combine specifically with each other, and the interaction between them is known as the antigen-antibody interaction or antigen-antibody reaction. And these reactions are the basis of origin of species determination. They are also abbreviated as AGAB reaction. They form the basis of all humoral antibody mediated immunity. They are used for the detection of disease causing agent and some non-specific antigens like enzymes, and also for the determination of species. When antigen and antibody action occur in vitro, they are known as the serological reactions. So the reaction between the antigen and the antibody occur in three different stages. First of all, the antigen. So what is antigen? Antigen is a foreign substance, or we can say the specific carbohydrate sequences which is present on the surface of the RBCs. And the antibodies are present in the plasma. So there is a formation of antigen-antibody complex first. After that, it will lead to the visible event like precipitation or agglutination, etc. Then the destruction of antigen or its neutralization will take place. So what are the silent features? Like, first of all, there must be specificity, and they will form an immune complex. There is a binding site of antigen and a binding force is present on the antigen, which will form an immune complex between the antigen and the antibody. First of all, what is specificity? Specificity refers to the ability of individual antibody combining site to react with only one antigenic determinant or epitope, that it will bind to a specific antigen determinant site. Each antibody binds to a specific antigen, and interaction is similar to that of a lock and key. As shown in the figure, there is an antibody having Y shape, and different epitopes or various antigens are here. So antibodies that presently match antigen shapes created an antigen-antibody complex. There are different types of antibodies as we know, like IgD, IgE, IgE, IgA or IgM, and they all have a different shapes. For IgD, IgG and IgE, it is having a Y shape. For IgA, it is a dimer, and IgM is a pentamer. How this immune complex takes place? An immune complex is formed from the integral binding of an antibody to a soluble antigen. So antigen and antibody combination make an antigen-antibody complex as shown in the figure. There are various types of antibodies which bind to a particular epitope of an antigen and form an antigen-antibody complex. What is the binding site? So binding site, it is a part of antigen which combines with antibody, and it is also known as the epitope, which is recognized by the immune system, especially by the antibodies, B cells and the T cells. So part of an antibody that recognizes an epitope is known as the paratope. So on antibody, we will be having paratope, and on antigen, we will be having an epitope. So epitope of antigen combined with the paratope of antibody and form an antigen-antibody complex. What is the binding force? There must be some force which attracts the antigen and antibody to form a complex. The binding between antigen and antibody in antigen antibody reaction is due to the three factors. First one is closenessness, how they are close to each other. So closenessness between the antigen and the antibody, they are more close or more good or strength of binding. Next is the non-covalent bond or the intermolecular forces. There are different types of non-covalent and intermolecular forces like hydrogen bond, van der Waals force, hydrophobic bonds. These help in the binding of the antigen to the antibody. Third one is the affinity of antibody. How much is the affinity of the antibody? So the strength of reaction between a single epitope and a single paratope is known as the affinity of an antibody. These are the three basic factors which help in the binding of antigen to the antibody. First one is closenessness, bonds formation like non-covalent or the intermolecular forces, and the affinity of an antibody. Time. There are different types of antigen-antibody reaction. The first one is precipitation reaction and the second one is agglutination reaction. Binding of antibodies to antigen inactivates antigens by neutralization, block viral binding sites, causes bacteria, as shown in the figure, bacteria is neutralized by the antibodies. Next one is the agglutination of microbes. Then the precipitation of dissolved antigen, in this case dissolved antigen react with the antibodies. There is agglutination, surface antigens react with the microbes. Then there will be activation of complement system. There is a huge complement system which is present in our body, and there is a cascade of these complement system which help in the lysis or the phagocytosis of the foreign substances. First type of reaction is precipitation or immunoprecipitation. So what is precipitation? It is a phenomena of aggregation of sensitized antigens on addition of specific antibody or precipitin to antigen in a solution, which is known as a precipitation. They are basically a serological reaction which are used to determine the origin of species from a different kinds of tissues or a blood. So what is the principle behind the precipitation reaction? In precipitation reaction, we will take a blood serum. As we know, it contains proteins in colloidal suspension, and when the human serum is injected to an animal, the animal becomes immunized against these proteins and antibodies develop in the blood. If the human serum is then brought into contact with the animal serum, the antibodies in the animal serum react with the protein in the human serum, and the visible precipitate form. The antibodies causing this reaction are known as the precipitins, and the animal serum is known as the anti-human precipitin serum. A rabbit or a frog is injected with the human blood every third day for 3 to 6 injections. After this, the animal is killed and the anti-serum is collected. A suitable anti-serum should be react immediately or within a minute, that is 1:1000 dilution. So this is the principle of the precipitin reaction. If you are not a part of the solution, you are a part of a precipitate. Precipitation reaction can be occur in two media. It may be occur in the liquid as well as in the gel. So how the precipitation takes place in the liquid? We have to place a constant amount of antibodies in a series of tubes. After that, we will be adding some amount of antigen in each tube. Antigen-antibody reacts together, resulting in a precipitin. So we can plot the amount of precipitate against increasing amount of antigen concentration, which help in yield a precipitin curve. Precipitin curve show three zones. So first one is zone of antibody excess, then zone of equivalence, then third zone is zone of antigen excess. This is a graph plot between the antigen added as well as the antibody in precipitate. In zone of antibody excess, excess antibodies are there. In zone of antigen excess, there are more antigen, but the concentration of antibody is very less. But in case of zone of equivalence, we will be having equal amount of antigen as well as the antibody, which will form a lattice-like structure and form a precipitate, which will help in determining the origin of species. As we discuss the principle, there is a soluble antigen plus antibody which form a visible precipitate like a lattice-like formation, where antigen binds with the Fab sites of the antibody and form a lattice-like structure which is visible in nature. Now the precipitation in gel. As we discuss, precipitation can be take place in the liquid as well as in the gel. How it will take place in the gel? The process is known as the radial immunodiffusion. In these methods, agar gel or a similar gel are used on the plates or petri plates. Both the antibodies and antigen diffuses freely in the gel system in all the directions. After that, at a certain point, depending upon the rate of the diffusion and the concentration of the reactant, a zone of equivalence will be formed, which is seen as a visible precipitate. If antigen or antibody preparations are complex, multiple bands form. There are again two types, single diffusion method and a double diffusion method. First one is a picture of a single diffusion method, and later on the picture is of double diffusion. In single diffusion, or we can say radial diffusion, we will place the antigen in the center of a gel and antibodies at the far, they are placed at the far away. As soon as the diffusion takes place, a precipitate forms ring-like structure. A visible ring precipitate is formed. Whereas in double diffusion method, on agar plate, we will place antibody on one side and antigen on the other side. When the diffusion takes place, they will form a precipitate line in between. So this is the how the precipitation reaction takes place in a gel. Immunodiffusion, it is a technique for studying reactions between antigens and antibody by observing precipitates formed by the combination of a specific antigen and antibodies which are diffused in the gel in which they have been separately placed. So both the antigen and antibodies are separately placed and they are diffused in the gel and form a precipitate line as discussed earlier. So conclusion. So we conclude that the fact that the antigen and antibody reactions are very important for serological testing of human beings, as they give a complete picture of all the immune responses occurring in the body and help in determining the origin of species as well as the immunological disorders by the antigens. So conclusion. So we conclude that the fact that the antigen and antibody reactions are very important for serological testing of human beings, as they give a complete picture of all the immune responses occurring in the body and help in determining the origin of species as well as the immunological disorders by the antigens.